Assalamu alaikum. Hope you all are fine. This is Miras Hussain Moon, your ICT teacher, Cantonment Public School and College, Soidpur. This is my first class with you in our official YouTube channel. And today, I am going to discuss about the importance of ICT. So before starting anything, first we have to know what is actually ICT. ICT means Information and Communication Technology. So all the technology which are used for passing the informations or sending the informations and for the communications, those devices are ICT devices. So all the things actually which are actually related to the informations and communications, those are the ICT device. In today's world, it's really difficult to think about any field without the ICT devices. All the fields like medical, in the research, in the educations, in the communications, and for the defense systems, it's really tough to think a field without ICT. From morning to night, we are actually connected with several ICT devices in our real life. Actually, we can't imagine today's modern life without ICT. First of all, I'm going to discuss about some implementation of the ICT in our Bangladesh. All the government services are now being provided with the ICT. Now you can take all the informations and all the services from your home with the help of a smartphone or a laptop. The second things I'm going to discuss, that is the importance of ICT in the getting job. So right now, it's not mandatory to have a certificate to achieve a job. You can easily access to the job market if you are really skilled on any specific work. So if you have the ICT devices and if you're really skilled in any job, you can easily access the job field without any certificate. So there is no age limit, there is no certificate for your income right now. And in this field, the young generation of Bangladesh has really stepped forward and they have gained an excellent positions in the world. You can easily imagine about the working field in this pandemic situation. So all the employees of different fields in these situations, they're actually working from their home. There is a lot of fields where it is not necessary to come the employees at any office. They are just doing their job, they are just doing their formalities all from their home with the help of the ICT devices. And the uses of the ICT has opened a different job sector in our Bangladesh. You can just think about the mobile phone. There was a time where these devices were not so popular in our Bangladesh, but right now we all have the mobile phone. Actually, the number of the users of mobile phone is proportional to our the population. Almost all of our populations are using mobile phone nowadays. So this has opened a new job field. There is a lot of people developing their careers in these mobile sectors. Some people are working for the marketing, some people are working for the maintenance, and some people are working for the advertisement. So a new job has been added for the use of the mobile phone. And also the software engineers are coming to this field for developing new softwares and games for the user. So it's really important that how important the ICT in our daily life. So if you don't use the smartphone, if you don't use this mobile in this age, so a lot of people will remain unemployed today. So on that point, it's really important to have the mobile phones in our daily life. The second important things I'm going to discuss, that is the communications. So what is the communications? So communication is the process by which informations or data are sent from one point to another point. Before, 50 or 60 years ago, it was really tough to think about today's communications. So on that time, actually birds and different means are used to send the data from one place to another place. Right now, we can simply access any point of the world within milliseconds with the help of the ICT devices like Messenger, like WhatsApp, like Skype. There's a lot of softwares and the ICT devices for the communications. And day by day, we are being introduced with some new kind of interactive communications. Today, we have a lot of softwares and a lot of ICT devices by which we can make a video call with different users. And the softwares and the devices are being too much interactive that we can even hold a meeting being in different places of the world. And we are already introduced with these systems. We have already made all of our classes with the help of Zoom. So we have already taken your classes with the help of Zoom, where you all were in different places, but it has connected in a specific platform, like a meeting. So we can arrange nowadays these kinds of meetings with the help of software. So it is also helping us to continue the remote communications. Before 30 or 40 years ago, we are dependent on the broadcasting media like radio and the televisions. Those media actually are not interactive. On that system, it was really tough to make interactive connections on that time. But right now, it is possible with the help of a smartphone. And for developing this communication sector, a lot of communications equipment has been implemented and invented nowadays, and lots of are being developed day by day. Think about the newspaper. In a specific time, it was a functioning media all over the world. But right now, actually we are not getting informed not only by the newspaper, because all the news sources right now we have in different social media and in different websites in our smartphone. So for the news, we are not dependent on the newspaper nowadays. We can simply get access to any information or any news simply by using the internet. Now I'm going to discuss about the importance of ICT in the business sector. So a lot of things has been changed for the implementation of ICT in the business sector. Suppose you have created something new or you want to launch something new in our market. And before launching that product, you want to make a survey from the people of that specific region. So simply, you can take the help of ICT and you can make a survey within a short time with the help of the information devices. Suppose you have a store in your locality and there is a million of products on your store, and you can simply have the accounts all of your products by using a computer. You can simply calculate how many products are being sold and how many are remaining. So in the business sector, it is playing an important role. And also for the publicity of some new products, you can use simply the ICT devices. And you can simply pay your bills with the click of your mobile phone. Like Bcash, Rockets, Nogod, a lot of softwares are now available to pay your bill from your home. As I have already told you that we are going to the way of building a digital Bangladesh, and government is implementing all sorts of new technology in different service area of the government. Now you can easily access to any government service just using different kind of ICT devices from your home. Suppose you are going to register for a new passport, you can simply make them applications from your home. Suppose you are going to have your exam results, you can simply access the exam board's websites by using your mobile phone or by sending a simple SMS. It's trying to providing their all kinds of services by different ICT devices. Suppose you are traveling to a new places and you have just forgot to bring your textbooks. But right now, you can easily download your textbooks from the government websites. You can also pay the taxes, so you need not face any kind of harassment before paying your taxes. Money transfer system has become so much easier that you can send any kind of money from just the click of your smartphone. Suppose you are just coming your home from any capital city or from any busiest city in the Bangladesh. You can simply book the seat of bus, train and launch by simply using a smartphone from your home. So traveling has become very easier with the help of ICT. So our next topic is healthcare. A remarkable changes has brought in the field of healthcare. But right now, the doctor can easily diagnose the patients before treating any medicines to the patients. The number of the doctor is not enough in proportion to the populations of our Bangladesh. But if we can implement the new sorts of technology in these healthcare systems, it would be really helpful for the people of Bangladesh. In the pandemic situations, we have also introduced with the telemedicine services. We can just simply dial a specific number and we can just communicate with the doctors. We can simply just tell our symptoms to the doctors and doctors have prescribed in different way with the help of the telemedicine. And our last topic is research. All the research related things are completely dependent on the ICT devices. All the hybrid drops, all the hybrid technology and all the mobile technology are completely based on the ICT devices. Our civilization is now advancing with the help of the research and development. And without the research and development, it would not possible to have these kinds of advancement nowadays. So for the research, it is mandatory to have different kinds of ICT devices. So all the research works are divided into two types. Number one is theoretical and number two is practical. So for the theoretical researches, you have to analyze with different kinds of data. And to analyze those different kinds of data is really, for the theoretical, it is really important to have the ICT devices in your hand. And for the practical works, you must have the ICT devices. That was all for today. Thanks for your patience and thanks for watching this video. If you really find it useful, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. Have a nice day. Thank you.